come with certain warnings. For example, when it comes to the WhatsApp family group, exit immediately. Immediately, it's a plan from the devil. It's the cuckest group in the world. It's usually started by unemployed people in the family. They've got fuck all to do in the day. All day copying and pasting Maya Angelou quotes. Exit immediately. Your daughter got no time for that cuck. Because, you know, they will trap you, as they did me. They will trap you normally beginning of November. They start that group and they go, no, please, you have to stay in the group because us as a family, we have to decide where we are going for Christmas lunch. You are trapped. You are trapped. And there's always the one aunt that starts with, my house is available. My house is available every year. My house. Nobody wants to go to her house. It's that one house where they've been renovating forever. Since my diva was on the island, their toilet is no longer klaar for entirely. Nobody wants to go. Not on Jesus' birthday. She says, my house is available. 30, 40 family members. You just hear crickets, crickets. Niemand for good. And I'm watching the group chat. Nothing's happening. And I just hear the sound of wings. And I hear the angel go, no, Mark, say. Say they can come to your house. The same angel from the robot. I make over time. She said, say, they can come to your house. And I thought, you know, maybe the family can now come to my house. Because, you know, 17 years ago, I walked up onto this very stage and I said, I come to you from the Cape Flats with love. And I can't say that anymore because I was moved out.
That's very hilarious. My cluttering has been in this funny business for nearly two decades and is a firm favorite, of course, of many South Africans here at home and abroad. His show, hashtag Luttering, enjoyed packed houses last year and is currently on at the Monte Casino in Johannesburg until the 17th of September. It covers a whole range of issues. It looks at people who live in debt, to the dangers of a WhatsApp group. In fact, a family WhatsApp group and many, many more other topics. He joins us now in a series in Johannesburg to look back at how far he's come in this industry, but most importantly, to look at this current show. Good morning to you and thank you so much for coming through.
Good morning. Wow, I can't believe people wake up looking like this. You look amazing. You must. how do you cope?
It's good to be here. I have to cope.
Okay.
I have to look this good for you.
Fantastic.
Yeah, this
Thank
is just
you very
for
much.
You, ne?
Thank you, just for me.
Just for you.
Wow.
Yeah, but why were you closing your ears to while we were playing one of your shows?
Do you ever watch yourself?
I do.
And how do you feel when you look at you? Okay, you don't answer that because we know you're perfect. But I'm a normal human being. I can't, like most people watching this morning,
but
I can't listen to
You've
myself.
You've been in this industry for two decades now.
Ish, you make me sound older. But yeah, I've been doing this for a long time.
No.
I don't imagine that there's any other job that I could be doing. So, and South Africans absolutely love stand-up comedy. Mm. People come out to support comedy more than anything else in the country. So I'm very happy because people have been helping me pay my bills for years.
No, we need to. I mean, with a whole lot of things that are happening in South Africa, we need to take a moment out to sit down and laugh. It's therapeutic, eh?
Yeah, honey, if we don't laugh at what's happening, if we don't laugh at what we see in the news, we will be very, very depressed. So in the show, I do cover a lot of... I try and stick to the hashtag stuff, but we also talk about a lot of topics that come up daily in South African news, which you can't avoid. And we find a way. We find a way to make people laugh about it.
And I wonder if you are still on your family WhatsApp group. I doubt you're still there.
I'm a decent person, you know, because I've got matric with exemption. I'm very well-mannered. So, because, you know, if you leave that family WhatsApp group, I don't know if you ever try to leave, because they can see you exit.
They can see ya.
And then they're very much, who does she think she is? So you can put that group on mute.
Okay.
But I say in the show that the family WhatsApp group, I believe, was started by unemployed people in the family.
Welcome.
Because they've got nothing to do the whole day. So they're on your daughter, copying and pasting Maya Angelou quotes. And then they still threaten you and tell you if you don't pass this on to 10 people, something bad will happen to you. So it can drive you to drink. So, but you mustn't be drunk though when you're on the family WhatsApp group, because if you are on that group, the chances are that you're privately skinnering with your cousin about the nonsense going on in that group.
So you can't be her safe
because you must know what you must post where. You must focus.
It's happened to you. It's happened to me before.
No, you want the.
It's happened to me before, but let's not even get there. Now, you're the son of a Cape Flats Pentecostal pastor. How has that reflected on you and your unique brand?
I grew up, as you say, my father was a pastor, so I grew up on the Cape Flats, so we went to church a lot. I don't know if you grew up going to church a lot.
I do, I still do. How much?
You don't look like a church girl, though.
But how do you identify one?
A church girl, because in the church they used to preach about the girls who look like the temptress, you know, who will make men wander away. You look like that kind of girl. But I'm not here to preach. It's just the way God's using me now to say these things to you. But let me get back to the topic. Your question was about the pastor, about the church.
And how is it reflecting on your brand as a comedian?
Exactly. I'm just saying what I'm feeling. Voices are speaking to me to pray for this girl. But I want to say that growing up, going to church all the time, I have a keen sense of people. I love people. Mm. And I love watching people. And in the church that I grew up in, we used to dance in church and we used to speak in tongues and run around. And so I'm very comfortable with being on stage. I'm very comfortable with making people happy. I think in another way, one could say I still preach the gospel. And of course, I still take a tenth of everybody's income because that's what we did in the church. Yeah. So it's very good. So I'm just sticking to the principles of the Bible.
Okay. And you come a long way from your days of from the Cape Flats with love. Look at you now.
Yes, you know, I look at those things when I started out from the Cape Flats with Love, the show that you mentioned was one of my earlier shows that I did. And now when I look back at that, because that was still on a VHS tape, and I sit and I look at it and I go, wow, Mark Lottering, is it possible to still look so hot? Because back from that time to where I am now, you know, God has been good. You still look great.
Next at Verander.
There we go. Next at Verander. So it's been a good journey.
Yeah.
I'm very grateful to still be doing what I'm doing now. And I mean, now we are at Monte Cassino and we know where I also have been years back, and to be back there is just awesome. So I'm happy that people are still coming to listen and that the people are still laughing, most importantly.
And still coming for your looks. I
wake up with these looks, and sometimes, you know, I've got to cope with it because you don't set out to look like this, but some of us just have gifts, and you'll know what I'm talking about. And some days I wake up and I look up to the heavens and I say, please, I just want to be average today. But I can't, because God's got a different plan for all of us.
Yeah. Is it your crown?
Die hare. Yeah. Oh, die hare. I'm over with die hare. It's real. I'm very happy about the fact that I decided years ago, because my mother lied to me when I was growing up, because a lot, my mother said to me, hey, you know, when you grow your hair, you've got straight hair. Mm. It actually hangs over your left eye, but we just keep it short.
And it's
for
not
school.
The case.
My maat gelig. Because when I grew it, I saw this whole thing going on. I think it's from all the years of tear gas and running from Caspers that the hair is standing like this. But I believe there's a lot of power in hair. So I enjoy my hair, and I think it takes me far in comedy
Well. We'll leave it at that. It's month end. I'm not going to let you say anything about month end. I've been hearing beeps from my phone, and I know it's month end.
Are you avoiding the call centers,
It's
my
not
friend?
The call centers, man. It's the debit orders
you,
going
you
off.
You lie to call center agents. Hold there. They phone me and they go, can I speak to M. Lottering? I say, he passed away. And they don't even listen. They say, and what time will you be back?
Let's leave it at that. But of course, your show continues until the 17th of September.
Please, people must come. Monte Cassino Theatre every night at 8 o'clock from Wednesdays to Saturdays. And they must come.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Always
a pleasure talking to you.
Great meeting you. I can't believe you're real. It's like I want to touch you afterwards. We'll do a selfie.
We'll do a selfie. Yeah. Hey, this guy. 8:30, time for your headlines.